Can you describe your emotions as you're about to introduce the film and share it with fans here at TIFF?
It's kind of a bit overwhelming. It's been a film that I first thought about making 20 years ago when I read the book. And to be here now, back at TIFF, where I began my career, I had my first film played here in 2001. So it's a bit overwhelming, actually. And to bring my young cast, you know, Ilsa, who's in her first film, and to see her doing the red carpet was gorgeous. It's at the beginning of her career.
What was it about that original story that caught your imagination, and why was now the right time in your career and perhaps in the world for this story to come to screen?
Yeah, it's interesting, isn't it, that it feels like it's more relevant than ever. I feel like the plight of our natural world and of the oceans and all the stories of environmentalism are more important than ever. And I think there was a sense of it back when it was written, but I think we've galvanised a lot of force. I feel very optimistic that this is the moment to show a film like this, a film that's quite political about saving our oceans. But look, I really cared about it when I first read it years ago because it was a personal story, a mother and a child, really, and a fish. And so even though it has this global ambition, you know, it's quite an intimate drama. But no, I think the timing's perfect.
Can you talk a little bit about capturing that authentic age progression for your central character? Obviously, three amazing actresses playing the part.
Yeah, when you've got to have one character played by three actors, that's a challenge. Ariel Donahue, Ilsa Fogg, and the wonderful Mia Wasikowska, these three incredible actors. And my wife's a casting director. She casts the actors in all my films, many films that have played at TIFF. She's got a great eye for casting. And I think her guidance in trying to find these three women so that they could play the one person was spot on. And, you know, I think it'd be great to see what audiences make of it, because you need to know that they're the same person at any given time, and I think you do.
Of course, Eric Banner is a welcome addition to any cast, any cinema experience. But I think in this film, he's obviously playing something maybe a little different from the kind of, you know, polished leading man that we normally see him as. Can you talk a bit about his character and what he has to say in the story?
Yeah, Eric Banner, one of Australia's greatest actors. I directed him in the film The Dry recently. And I love seeing him do a character role. You know, this big, eccentric abalone fisherman with great compassion and a big heart. And his friendship with this young girl is just fantastic. And it was wonderful for me to see Eric do something playful after The Dry, which was a more serious drama, and to see him embrace the kind of the character and the life and the energy of this character is something, I think for him even, quite unique in the canon of his quite extraordinary performances.
The film authentically takes us deep beneath the waves. Why was it important for you to have your cast do that, and what are you hoping an audience takes away from the vicarious experience of life under the water?
Yeah, I wanted to take the audience there. You know, I really believe, you know, the Jacques Cousteau quote, you know, if you make people love something, they'll care for it. I'm really hoping that Blueback's part of that tradition and that we can take an audience somewhere incredible and inspire a kind of greater love of something that we do kind of at this moment in history have to care for. So that's really the hope, and that's why we shot on big large format lenses, and you know, and it's quite spectacular underwater footage.
Of course, very famously, you know, Spielberg proved that working with animatronics and water can be quite a perilous pursuit. Can you talk a little bit about working with amazing creature effects underwater here?
Yeah, we had the incredible partners at Creature Technology. You know, they made this amazing puppet fish, you know, coming from the tradition, as we know, of E.T. and Yoda and Jaws, and cinema loves puppets. I think at a time when you can watch a film that's 80% VFX, it's amazing to actually have a film, you know, that embraces an old-fashioned style of technology. I loved it. They researched the fish. They four trained puppeteers with gills and the mouth and the fins. Delightful. The actors actually found it fun, because when they were interacting with the puppet, it was real. And Mia Wasikowska said to me, she forgot. She was in the water swimming and she forgot it was a puppet.
How does it feel to be a part of TIFF and to be sharing the film here with fans?
Oh, it's so exciting. It's such a treasure and a pleasure and a privilege. And, you know, I got in yesterday, you got in the day,
yeah,
before, so it's a bit dizzying. But it's a beautiful city, and obviously it's an amazing festival. And this theatre, I don't know if you've seen it, is stunning. So I can't wait. I actually haven't seen the film finished, so this will be a real pleasure for me.
Well, Blueback, it's sort of about, it's about relationships, really. Our relationship the characters have with the ocean, but also with each other. And it's just, I mean, this is girl, Abby, who I play, and who I play the teen version of, and Mia Wasikowska plays the older version, and Ariel Donahue the younger version. And she befriends this fish in the ocean, which she calls Blueback. And I guess the whole film kind of surrounds this journey she takes trying to protect this bay from developers and people that want to make this small little coastal beautiful town on Western Australia's coast into a massive big city. And I guess she takes inspiration from her activist mother, and with all this determination and passion she has, she becomes a marine biologist in the end. And I think it's got an environmental message at its heart, but also the relationship she has with her mother and the blueback, the fish as well. So yeah.
Well, I love this character, Dora. I mean, it was so much fun being Ilse's mom, but especially because we got to have adventures together. Dora, like, drives a speedboat, she free dives, she teaches her daughter, her, like, 10-year-old daughter how to dive. So she's kind of ballsy, I guess, and she's passionate and she's courageous. She's impassioned. She's the one who sort of wants to be the custodian of this bay and to turn it into a marine park. And if you watch the film, you see that in the sort of passing of her life, that's her legacy. That was something she was able to accomplish. That being said, I think it sort of leaves you with a sense of the agency that we have as individuals, and how what we do counts. So I guess the character meant a lot to me, just having to be able to swim in her fins, so to speak.
A lot of this takes place underwater, and you guys really did that. Can you talk about why it was important for the story that you authentically went under the water, and what audiences could get out of that experience?
I think it's important that we really did do it, because I guess
we know what it feels like.
We know what it feels like, and it's true. Like, we were really down there, and I think it allows people to, like, know that they're capable of doing the same, going down there to such, like, 20 meter depths, holding their breath up to 2 minutes. And I mean, I didn't even know that I was capable of doing such until I tried, and I think that we really did it. It makes people, like, believe that they can. Yeah,
it leaves you also with it's sort of meditative experience, so yeah. It sort of leaves you
really is, yeah,
with a different sense of yourself, actually, and of your connection with the ocean. Which I had in a sort of theoretical way before, but having shot the film, we felt a little bit like fish, I guess.